In order to determine the force that the pin C and D exert on member ECD of the frame, we can start by developing the free body diagram of the member ECD and listing down all the external loads and the support reactions exerted on the member. To start, I have a horizontal load of 800 pounds acting in the X direction, whereas at point C and D, we have our pin support. Now for point D, I have the two support reactions TX and TY for the pin, whereas the member CB is a two force member. So the force will be exerted along the axis of the member and can be represented by FCB along the axis. Now we can identify the direction of that axis by the right angle triangle given by a base of 1 foot and the perpendicular distance of 2 feet. It is giving us the hypotenuse of root 5. Next, we can identify the position of point C with respect to D and list down its distance from point D of 2 feet in the vertical and 2 feet in the horizontal direction. Once we have listed all the external loads and support reactions and the dimensions, we can go ahead and start applying our equilibrium equation. Now to start, we can apply our summation of moment at point D equals to zero. This will eliminate both dx and dy as they are not going to create any moment. Next, the force FCB can be divided into vertical and horizontal component, and we can identify the moment these forces create with respect to point D. So to start, the vertical component of force FCB can be calculated by multiplying it with a ratio of 1 over root 5. Here the moment arm is 2 feet and it is creating our clockwise moment, that's why it is given as negative, whereas the horizontal component is calculated by multiplying it with 2 over root 5. Again, the moment arm is 2 feet and it is creating our clockwise moment as well. Finally, the 800 pound of external load is creating our counterclockwise moment. Simplifying, we get our value of FCB as 1,788.8 pounds. Next, we can go ahead and apply our summation of forces along the horizontal axis equals to zero and simplify to get our value of dx, which is coming as 800 pounds. Finally, we can apply our summation of forces acting along the z direction equals to zero and add all the loads acting along the z direction. Here I have FCB component going vertically upward that can be calculated by multiplying 1788 with 1 over root 5, plus I have my dy going upward on my free body diagram. This gives us the value of dy as negative 800 pounds.